Hello everyone, welcome to PixelJellopyBits Gaming, or Place, sorry, that's my old name. So, I'll be just doing some dungeon quests for Scaraba, level 2 for this character of mine, and then probably I'll be doing leveling for my assassin characters, and if I still have the energy, I can do some instance run again. So same old run like faceworm and other instances I have checked before. I'll try to clear other previous instances that you haven't saw yet in this game. So feel free to tune in, and thank you very much for watching. So I'll just be silent for a while. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Frontera. So, thank you for visiting the stream. Thank you very much. So, in terms of my favorite Ragnarok Online background music, probably, I think I have a few in mind. One of which is the Frontera Forest background music. I like that. I also love the background music of Geffen. And then, I think for other two music backgrounds, I like the Eclage Town theme song, and then also for Eldikas. So that's my favorite music. Thanks. Again, hi Frontera. So again, to repeat my favorite music. So sorry if you cannot hear earlier. So my favorite background music are Geffen, the town theme Geffen, and then I like Frontera Forest sound, the background theme, and then for other areas, I like the Eldikas and then Eclage. Yeah, favorite town. So, for my favorite town, actually, you can see it right now. Peon is my favorite town, basically. So it's my hangout spot for my characters. So I just teleported back to Peon because I might die while speaking to your answering your comment. So. So those are some of my answers. Just a moment, I'll take uh so far, further ado, do you have other questions like about, I guess the classes? Like the characters, yeah, the classes you like to play, or any other stuff about Ragnarok Online, so. I'll just fix my equipment, so I might move to another leveling ground. Yeah, probably I'll go to, since I'm level 130 and Scaraba dungeon, you cannot unlock the bounty board for Scaraba Dungeon. I might go to probably probably to Juno, the Juno Dungeon, yeah. Yeah, Giffen is more of, I guess, even though I like to hang out in Payon, I think the music of Giffen fits my mood. Yeah, also, Protera, thank you for hanging out to my stream. So, I probably... play other MMOs next year. So right now I'm just trying to get a hang of Twitch. I think I put it on a slow mode. Oh wait, I can see it in my. Dashboard. Just a moment. I'll just double check. Okay, so I think it's not turned off. Okay, and it's now on slow mode. Sorry, I'm still new to Twitch, basically. So for RO, I think I discovered RO when it came out on 2003 or 2004. Yeah, so I just got a CD from a anime magazine that I have, and then I installed the game and then downloaded it, and during that time it was still Intel 4 and Intel 3 days, so it took a long while to download, but I was able to play the classic or 1.0 version of Ragnarok Online. Yeah, so that's how I discovered the game, from a advertisement from an anime magazine which has a free installer CD of Ragnarok Online. I see, yeah. Probably I haven't turned on the slow mode because I'm also looking at Streamlabs, so I apologize. I'll probably turn on it next time, probably. Yeah, and also, usually I don't have any people watching my stream, so sometimes I tend to focus on what I'm playing, and then got surprised, like having you right now. So I'll probably change my character and I might need to transfer some items. So no worries. So I main assassin classes for the most part while I'm playing. For your question regarding War of Imperium, I used to be active on Guild War, less on PvP. I think I think on 2016. I was very active here in International Ragnarok Online in terms of the Guild War scenario. And then I stopped around 2020 or 2019. I need to have a break back then since I was in the transition of a new job, and then I just when I already have a job, and then I was able to have time more for playing Ragnarok Online. But eventually, I became more of a PvE or player versus environment player, and less on Guild War. Then in terms of PvP, I join PvP. Number one, I don't have fast fingers to switch from one item to another or switch armor from one on another. And of course, it's very hard to take down fast enemies like Sura, so they can just one hit you with Gates of Hell, and then unless you have poison in your katar, you can silence them. And then also for other tanky characters, like if the enemy is a royal guard that is very well equipped, and then probably on 1v1 occasions I probably be very competent on 1v1, but in terms of dealing with more than two enemies at a time, I had some difficulties on it, especially if they have a support and then they have strong items as well. here. So this is some of the items I needed. So just a moment. Most of the time I post solo MVP videos, like killing bosses, just a single character. I used to do that way back. Right now it's more of casual streaming. Then I'm also waiting for the fourth job classes expansion, and it's already available in GRO, KRO, then Taiwan RO. So not sure when it will be implemented to international RO or the US RO server. Now I know, I think we will go to Juperos, since I still have, not sure if in the Ragnarok Online game we're playing, if you're playing right now or casually, there's what we call the bounty board. So this is a very efficient way to level. So you will probably hunt a number of monsters on a specific dungeon and then level up. Yeah, so you will basically turn in your kill and then gain a huge number of experience. Consumables, I just need to update my supply. Probably you might hear some background noise in my stream, because people are already preparing for the New Year. The New Year's Eve later. And having some fun. Okay, so probably we're okay right now, so let's just, yeah, so let's go to Juperos. So if you have any questions, you can just type it in the chat box. So I'll just try to manage and answering them if I'm not engaged in any enemies. Enemy summon. Activate the button.
Thank you.
Hello again. So we just finished with Juperos and we already completed the bounty board for all of the monsters found in the dungeon. So we'll go to another area, probably in Manok Field. I need to hunt the following monsters. Let's see. Probably the reason why I'm collecting all of the kill, so because there's an efficient way for leveling here in IRO, especially when there is a vent. Yeah, for example, you already gathered all the kills you want at a specific level on your level cap, so we can use a battle manual, for example, and then try to claim all of the experience, and then it will be a level booster character. So if I claim all of the kills I have right now, I'll probably jump to 134 135, based on the number of monsters I killed. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm trying to gather all the kills first before trying to claim them from specific towns. So right now we're now going to Manok Field. We'll try to hunt for Hills Lion, Centipede Larvae. Not sure if we have a centipede there, so I need to update my items, my equipment, for anti-insect or anti-brute damage, since Hills Lion is a brute type, Centipede Larvae is a insect. And I need some damage boost for poison type monsters. Probably use a undead armor for this one to try to mitigate the effects of poison status. So we got a card, surprisingly, so Venato card. So this is probably for characters for Agi type, depending on luck. So if you have like a, for example in my case, if I'm using a critical Qatar assassin, so this would be helpful for additional luck or critical. But in this kind of, I mean in Renewal right now, so that card is not very highly significant because of some strong items. transfer phase, so now we're going to manhwa and try to hunt these monsters.
Thank you.
So for Frontera, so to answer your question, yes, I've played Ragnarok for a very long time, probably more than 10 years. In terms of why, what the things I like from this game, probably number one is the story, the lore. After a few years of playing the game, I was able to buy the manga or the manhwa. Remember, Ragnarok Online was based from a comic book by Lee Myung-jin, so a Korean comic book writer. So I was able to read the story from that manga and became familiar with the characters featured in the game. So for example, I think some servers, the name of the servers in Ragnarok Online are Chaos, Irene, Fenrir, Loki. So I didn't realize that those names were from the actual comic itself. So for example, Loki was a assassin character. Chaos was a knight character. Fenrir was a magician or a warlock character. And then in terms of Iris, I think his character or job is on the soul linker side. Yeah, so Irene. So I think her job class is more of a soul linker. So also, if I think in the game, we have what we call instance dungeon. So some of those instance were based from the actual comic book. So I was really inspired, or really happy actually, in reading the comic book, even though it was not finished. It only has 10 volume, and the creator did not anymore create a continuation of the story in terms of the comic book. So sadly, I really want more stories or background about the characters like Chaos, Loki, Iris, Fenrir, also Lydia. So unfortunately, the creator didn't continue anymore the story, and we have the game right now, probably an expansion to the story, but the character is the players now this time. So in terms of the in-game lore, so probably what I like is the story behind the biology laboratory, biolabs. So I think some characters who are basically swordsman, archer characters, so basically they're real life characters in the game, and then they were turned into monsters. So I really like exploring the reason why they became experiments for the biolabs. So I really like that story. And then another story element from the game I like is the Ecclege. So I like exploring Ecclege, especially the background music. So that's one of the reasons why I really got connected to Ecclege, to Splendid, or so I really like the story elements. Then for other stories we have in game, think I like. Wait, just a moment. This one, episode 16. I really like the story behind this particular episode update. So, very much inspired by, I guess, Game of Thrones, because there are different factions of the rich families trying to gain power. Yeah, so, or gaining influence to the Kingdom of Frontera. So basically, you will be working with the elites in this episode. Then episode 15, Phantasmagorica. Very much science-like. I think it's probably for those who like scientific sci-fi stories. So I guess those are some of the stories I am quite familiar and very like right now. So for episode 17, I haven't fully explored this story yet, so right now I'm just trying to gain familiarity back with the game. Probably, let's see, next year if I'll try to finish some quests, because I still have pending quests for Terra Gloria and Banquet of Heroes. So since I play a lot of assassin characters, so I have to make all of their unlockables available already. So right now I stopped playing the story in episode 16.1, and I'll try to clear them, reach Terra Gloria, and then reach Illusion. So yeah, some of the stories I'm quite familiar and very in love with.
I see.
Learning the lore after playing the game. So, I think... when I started playing the game, I also don't know much about the lore. It's more of because I like anime, and the characters are designed that way. So that's how I really got into the game first. So I won't also judge in terms of not being able to be familiar with the lore. I guess it's more on how you invest in the games, because some people just play Ragnarok for the social experience, so you can talk with your friends, spend time with your guildmates back then. Some play only for PvP or War of Imperium, so no fault on not getting familiar with the lore, because I also invest time in reading about it. And also, here in IRO, so since we're behind in terms of the updates, so I'm getting news about the new classes, and I don't have much background about how the story is already at the current in Taiwan, in Korea, in Japan. So I guess that's a frustration of mine, not receiving the updates very quick. Because I also want to know more about how some of the consistent characters in the game are now playing the story. Yeah, also sometimes I'm sure if you also do this, so sometimes I also hang out in the PvP room, even though my character's already dead. I just try to spend time with other characters, just laughing and just seeing some very, I guess, overconfident characters getting smacked by strong players. So I think PvP in RO is a very good social experience. And for comedy and fun, that's one of the things I like in doing PvP. And then you can create your own party, you can try to clear the people by joining forces, so that's what I also love about PvP.
Thank you.
Okay, so I might just probably take a break because based from the number of kills I have, I think Hills Lion will take a long time. So I probably don't want to bore you guys doing the same dungeon. Yeah, so I guess try it. I guess I'll spend some time here right now doing some storytelling. So if you guys have any questions or I would like to share some of your experience in Ragnarok Online, feel free to chat them in the chat box. Okay, so I know I'm just taking a break, a rest. So probably just for a meantime, I'll probably just tell the viewers that probably continue streaming until this coming year. So probably not just Ragnarok Online. Probably stream Final Fantasy 14. Starting next year. Just need to get familiar with the controls again. I stopped early this year because I have some issues with my computer, so I need to have a revamp or basically buy a new PC to stream again. So apart from that, I also play RPG games. Like for example, Persona games, Final Fantasy, and other turn-based, or also Fire Emblem. I play tactics game. So I'll probably stream that in my channel next year. So basically I'm slowly building up my audience one by one, trying to get as many followers as I can in the process, and probably stream a variety of gaming content. The slow mode, so current probably remove it right now, so I'll just open my dashboard. So again, I'm not yet familiar with Twitch, so I'm just getting a hang of streaming as of late. I'll just update the Twitch. Okay, so already turned off. Yeah, thanks. Actually, thanks for giving me advice. So I'm very new to Twitch as a streamer and a viewer. So feel free to give me some feedback. So probably today I'm probably doing some high level dungeon. So maybe tell a bit some story about the dungeon or the instances. So I'm just preparing for it. For your question, so actually I have another account which is full of male characters. So actually this is my third account, and my first two accounts are male characters. So I just want to try how female characters look, particularly Guillotine cross characters. I have five Guillotine cross characters with level 175 over job level 60. So three male characters and then two female characters, and then I have some mid-level Guillotine cross characters, both male female. Basically, the reason why I'm playing female characters, I just want to see how they look with some gears I have. But I also have my male characters. Probably use them next time. Here's my high level character. So in this server, recently the level cap was expanded to 185 over 70. So if you're 185, so this is how your character looks now. Now I'm trying to, I guess, gather some Zenny so that I can level up to 185. Fireworks are getting louder, and you can also hear the baby from our neighbor's side. apologize for that sound. To another character of mine because I have some items there. So again, it's the same 175-60. So for these characters I have, so I usually use them to clear high level dungeons and instances. Dance dungeons. So some dungeons will be very easy for my level, so I guess the reason why I'm would like to clear them, maybe just tell some story about the dungeons, because some of them are based from a Korean comic book. Original Ragnarok manga by Lee Myung-jin. Now we'll be starting our first instance dungeon. So this will be much of a warm-up dungeon. So the reason I'm clearing this dungeon is for buff items. So if you're not a VIP character like
right now I am not subscribed to a VIP service. So if you want some buff items or buff effects, you can get it from here. So this dungeon is called the Sarah's Memory Instance Dungeon. So the level cap is 99 above. So the dungeon is set on Payon, where we're talking about the story of Sarah Irene and Iris Irene from the manga or the manhwa. So basically in this dungeon, this basically I will be a farming. Or if I farming clear. So what we have here is the younger version of Sarah, who eventually became the one of the antagonists in the game. So again, we'll just be farming some buff items here, since the mobs are very easy to defeat. So what happened earlier is the young Sarah saw her mother dead. So our mission right now is to look for the young Sarah. So the reason why we're being attacked right now is because the father eventually blames us for what happened to the mother of Sarah. The manga for this particular dungeon or instance, you will have more context or background about this dungeon and about the story of Sarah. Just going around Payon and walk around and defeat enemies. Damage for SP, so that's why I'm not running out of SP. now we're in the final stage for this dungeon. So we will be fighting Doi and Irene, the father of Sarah, and also Iris. So I'll just switch to my demi-human setup. So we have the glorious bloody roar. So another gear or garment. I just want to see the damage, the raw damage without the enchant deadly poison buff, which is a waste in this dungeon. So I have 150 CRS damage in the mid, no enchant deadly poison buff or minimal buff. So based from our conversation with Doyen, so he mistaken me, the player character, as the one who killed his wife or Sarah's mother. So the whole dungeon run is a misunderstanding. So I managed to eliminate all of his soldiers and pets by accident. You can see here, those two figures covered in black are the ones responsible for this misunderstanding. So if you read the manga or the manhwa, you can see how they look and which faction those two people are serving. So right now we're finished with the Memorial Dungeon or instance. So I'll just get some XP rewards. So pretty minimal for this level already, but for 99 above, it's pretty significant. Yeah, for the Memorial Dungeon earlier, so I think it was on, not on chapter 1, probably, I mean not in volume 1, obviously, I think in volume 2, it has some mentions. So I think on this I think in the game's perspective, it's a different way of telling the story, and then from the manhwa, it's another way of telling the story. So I guess if you have time, you can try to read back, because I have my own personal copy of the manga or the manhwa. Now we're just storing all of the buff items. Going to another memorial dungeon, or instance. So here, so this is for more of mid to high level characters. For a while, I'll just take a toilet break and I'll be back in a few minutes. So, please wait for a while. Thank you very much. Hello, I'm back now. So I just checked my manga. So I guess I was correct. So some parts about the story of Sarah is on volume 1. And then we have also in volume 2. And the fireworks are getting louder. So I'll just finish this Memorial Dungeon and I might And I might take a rest already. And also apologies for my dogs, so they're getting surprised by the fireworks. And final memorial dungeon, we'll be finishing the face worm's nest. So it also appeared in volume 1 of the Ragnarok Into the Abyss manga or manhwa. So as you can see below, there is Chaos and there is Iris. Right now, we'll just do an easy mode for this memorial dungeon, so to make it very quick, because the major difference for the easy mode and the hard mode is you will hunt more enemies on the hard mode, so it will take too much longer time in clearing the dungeon. Going back to our main build, which is the Meteor Assault build. So that will be most of my offense for this dungeon. So in terms of our story for this particular dungeon, so our role is to try to catch up on Chaos and Iris, because they're planning to kill the Faceworm Queen boss monster. So the reason why it's called Faceworm, because as you might have seen earlier, the monsters have a human looking face, but not in front, but on their beard, like an old man face beard, but looks like a human. So the whole process is just leeching damage while killing the monsters. And then kill the secondary boss, which is the Dark Faceworm. So on the first part, so after killing a number of Faceworm, we have the first Dark Faceworm boss. So it uses a poison attack, but this time the second Dark Faceworm boss would be using another element. So we just defeated the second Dark Faceworm boss. So as you can see, I was being targeted by Water Ball. So I need to backslide, lure the boss out from its range, so it will cast another Water Ball setup. for the third dark phase worm, so another mechanic again. So the mini boss will cast some cocoons below him, which can explode and deal fire damage. So the best way is to deal DPS as quick as possible, and then if not, just backslide. So for the fourth level of this dungeon, so the area will be covered by poison clouds. So if you don't have a poison property armor, this would be very dangerous for you. But I guess for me, I'm very much familiar with the mechanic, and I can actually evade the poison clouds. So for the fourth dark phase worm, so it will cast a wide poison cloud area of effect. So since I have a faster DPS, I can kill it quickly before the boss will cast the poison cloud. So right now we're going to the final boss, the phase worm queen. Quite a while.
to finish because the boss has a large HP. The reason why I'm avoiding the boss right now because the boss can change into different elemental types, so the best way to okay so it's safe now so again the best way to defeat the boss is in its poison form and its earth form. So for Frank, I guess you can say you have a point. Dead because it has a low player base, so I understand your sentiment. So right now it's already changing to Earth attribute, so we can deal damage to it again. So I'll just use Hallucination Walk. So Hallucination Walk increases my flee by a huge number. Okay, so I'm getting hit by a water ball. Just need to avoid it, then lure the boss back to have a reset. So right now the boss is in rage mode, so we need to head back to the portal because when the boss casts a earthquake effect, it will definitely kill me. So my basic strategy is damage the boss in poison and earth property, and then avoid the boss in water and wind and rage mode. So now we're going back because it's in original poison mode. Going back to its water property, so we need to go outside again because it will cast some storm gusts. In terms of killing the boss, you can another conventional method in killing the boss is by luring the boss on the NPC. So earlier there are two NPCs who are talking before I start the final boss fight. So they will appear in random locations and you need to lure the boss and they will do the damage. That is the conventional for lower level players. As for me, I'm trying to be very efficient in this one since I didn't brought up any huge buffs, only basic buff and basic items. And I also have a few HP items. Ah, I died.
Sorry. Okay. Sorry, so I didn't brought too much HP items. I'll try again next time. So that's how I usually do it. So it's okay for me. I'll try again next time on the next day. So that's how my usual method in killing the boss. So pretty much late in my time zone, and first of all I would like to thank everyone for dropping by the stream. Didn't end well for this one, but I usually defeat the boss with the correct item. So I think one of the reasons why I didn't make it because I forgot to equip this headgear. So this one. So it would be easier for me to have this equipped, and I kind of forgot it for this particular run, so I'll try to not forget it next time. Yeah, so I guess the XP loss is that's not much factor to me, so I can get it anytime. Yeah, so I guess for this part, if you don't have any more questions about the game or this server or why I'm still playing this game, you can feel free to chat. But I guess for a little background about me, for the new viewers, I played this game since 2003, although not very consistent since I eventually have a job and then I just came back on 2015 and then been playing the game casually. And probably the reason why I'm not yet going to other more popular MMOs like Final Fantasy 14, because I just started them recently, so I'll probably stream them next year. So I'll try to stream about them, probably stream more Final Fantasy by next year. Yeah, so for this server, I'm still playing Ragnarok because I have a lot of items here, and then I casually play them. So I'll try to do better for my Faceform run next time. So these are very rare occasions that I get killed by the boss. So again, thank you very much, and this is PixelJellopyBits, or you can call me PixelJello. And thank you, thanks for watching, and Happy New Year. Probably in my time zone, it's already Eve of next year, or year 2023. Again, thank you very much, and see you guys next time. Bye. Bye-bye, guys.